Okay, this Hangout's live, Carl. So we are live and we're recording this. So basically, this is Carl Nagel and Adam Basua, and I am going to demonstrate how to create an ad for on your Facebook fan page. That's a post that we're using for our Paycation recruiting. Okay, so basically, what you're going to do in a nutshell is write up a post. And it's going to have a nice little marketing message at the top, and then you're going to boost that post. So I'm going to basically show everybody how to do that. Okay, so right now everybody can see this is my fan page, and I'm going to scroll down to show you the actual post that I used last week to recruit about 15 different people. I actually recruited just two so far, but out of these 15, but I'm still talking with the other ones, but they all showed interest and came to me wanting to know more. And how's that for nice internet marketing? Compared to back in the days when people would
For a
go out
few
and do more to
dollars.
the people, yeah, it's for especially for it only cost me, it cost me less than $15 to get that. You know, back in the days, people were going to the malls and talking to everybody they see, leaving cards everywhere, talking to everybody they see. Now, with this method, you're actually attracting people that are actually interested already in multi-level marketing, and giving them an opportunity to see your opportunity. So here's the ad that I created. This guy right here is Todd Dowell. He's our main upline, and he's the guy that's making six figures. That's him and his Ferrari. And so basically, I took an image from his fan page, and he's okay with that because he's basically is the one that's teaching us how to do this. And so you can use an image of yourself if you want. Maybe if you have a nice image of yourself, like in the be at the beach, or just I don't know, you can use any image, to be honest. You can find any marketing image, any attractive image that you'd like, and use it here. It doesn't matter. There's no right or wrong. You're going to want to test all kinds of different methods anyway. I can tell you right now, this is actually my second ad. The first ad was this one here. It was just my family. And I'll be honest, I didn't get anybody. Not one person did I reach. Now, that doesn't mean I won't try it again. I think I didn't have the right demographic included. So this next time we'll see what happens. But today, in fact, that's what I think I'll do. I'll put this ad again and see what happens. So I'll just put that same picture up and see if that works. I don't know. We'll see. So anyway, just wanted everybody to know if you can see the results of this ad, it reached 2,500 people. 48 people liked it. 26 people and commented on it. Okay. And if I click on this comments, you can see all the comments that were here. Okay. Now, not all these comments are actual people that were offered that were looking for my ad. These are some of these people are people on my team that have basically kind of what we call juicing it. So you're going to want to have, you know, a number of people from your team going on here and replying, because if you look at the message, it says, I was an MLM junkie jumping from one program to another until I found this guy and followed his Facebook formula that he gave me free when I joined his team. You can have it too. Say yes, I do below and inbox me for the info. So I had a few people on my team just put yes, I do, yes, I do, just because it looks nicer when there's some people that have actually, you know, responded. And so it kind of makes people say, oh, well, this is actually interesting. Let me check it out. Other people are interested in it as well. Let me see. So that's what you call juicing. So we went ahead and did that. But a lot of these, about 16 or 17 of these, were actual people that I didn't know. And they wanted to know more. So when they responded, I wrote, okay. And then I said, send a message to my inbox and I'll follow up with you. And these people, if you look, I'll go to my messages. You can see here are the people that actually showed interest, actual interest, and I'm still working with them as well. So, well, this person here just sent me a message. I'm already in that under Curtis. Oh, so this guy's already in Paycation. Oh, well. So he fell for my ad, even though he's already in Paycation. Well, good for him. All right, so we'll move on. Now, so I'm gonna go back to my page here, and let's go ahead and start figuring out how we're gonna do this. So now, first thing you gotta do is you gotta come up with some copy, and you gotta come up with an image. So I'm gonna go over to Todd's page. This is Todd's fan page. Okay, he's got tons of images on here that he's okay with us using. So I'm gonna scroll down, and here's all his images. I'm gonna click on photos. All right. And Carl, feel free to chime in if you have a question, okay?
Okay.
Okay. So anyways, here's one of the ads. These are all ad he's the reason why you see multiple pictures of the same photo is because Todd himself is actually putting ads in, and he's just using the same photo over and over again. So every time he uploads the same photo into a post, it adds it to his photo archive. So you can see he's doing ads for all these, and here's another ad he did. There's another. And there's another one here, another one here. And here's the one I chose with the hands out. So there's more. So basically he's using a lot of these images. Here's a good one too. Maybe I'll use this one instead. Let me click on that. Ooh, that's a nice one. Yeah, maybe I'll just use this one. No, I'm not going to use that one. Let's see what I'll do. Here's another good one here. So, I mean, it's just a matter of what you want to do. Now, I am going to talk about him, so I do want to find an image of him. But, again, you don't have to do that. Okay? So, let's see. Let's go. We'll use this one here. It's kind of nice. All right? So, all right, so let me go ahead. What I'm going to do is I'm going to save this image. Okay, let's take it. I'm going to download it. All right, and let's see, where did I save it to? Oh, geez, it went to my downloads, I guess. Okay, so I saved it. All right, let me close that. Now, if I want to see the ads he did and look at the copy that he did, I have to scroll down and find his ad because his ad's in here somewhere. Yeah. These are all ads. So here's one. I'm looking for 10 people who want to build a strong residual income working from home and travel the world. Learn my six-figure secrets for me personally. Please say I need more info below and send me a message. So that's one. So you can use this if you want. Use that copy. Don't try if you're not good at coming up with your own copy, use his. It's fine. It's not a big deal. Okay? We don't want to, you know, worry too much about it. And plus, you're going to want to split test it anyways. Okay, here's another one. Only 5 spots left to my super recruiter workshop, blah, 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 blah. Okay, another just more copy. This website, his fan page is a good page to get good copy. Who has $150 to invest and wants to build the business using social media? No 3-way calls, no meetings, no flying across the country. Say, I want in below and send me an inbox message. So, I mean, this is all good stuff. So, anyway, I'm going to go over here. I'm going to go to my page. And I'm just going to – right now I'm just off the – cuff, I'm going to come up with some copy that I'm going to come up with, that I'm going to create. So, concessions, what's that, Carl?
You're just asking them to comment. You're not putting a link in there. You want to start a conversation.
Yeah, you don't want a link in there. You basically want them to inbox you so you can start having a conversation with them privately.
Right.
How about this? Tired of jumping from one MLM, I'm going to put hashtag MLM because that makes it searchable, to another, every, you know, to another. I, let's see, tired of jumping from one MLM to another. I did that for years until I met this guy who showed me how to recruit on Facebook without bugging my friends and family.
Yeah, that's great. Okay.
That's pretty good, right? Yeah, so... tired of jumping from one MLM to another. I did that for years until I met this guy who showed me how to recruit on Facebook without bugging my friends and family.
Yeah, that's good.
So kind of short. Yeah, you want to keep it kind of short.
I'm not good at, you know, copying myself at all.
You know what? It's not easy. It's not. So it's nothing wrong with finding stuff that works and tweaking it. So tired of jumping from one MLM to another. I did that for years until I met this guy who showed me how to recruit on Facebook without bugging my friends and family. I'll share it with you too. Say yes, I do below, and inbox me for the info.
Yeah, that's good.
Or I can just put, say, show me below and inbox me for the info. Yeah, so that's not bad, right? I mean, it's probably not the best.
That's fine. I mean, it's...
Okay.
I would think. I mean, I...
All right, so then now you want to put an image. So you click on that, and let's go find my image. So now that I found the picture, I'm going to go ahead and click on it, and I'm going to hit open, and now you'll see the picture show up. Okay.
This is really easy.
Then I'm going to hit post. Okay. That's it. Now, what I want, before I actually place the ad, I want people to juice this. I want to get people from my team to juice this. So what you're going to do is you click on the picture, okay, which will take you to the ad itself, all right, and it'll open up. So then you copy this link, all right. So this is the team. This is our team chat. So I can go ahead and do this. Hey guys, need an ad blitz. Put the ad in there. I'll close that. Hit tune. So now everybody on my team, there's like 42 people on here. Hopefully 5 or 6 of them will come on to the, will see the ad, will come here, and will type in, you know, show me right here, like I said, and right here. And then, in fact, Carl, why don't you, can you do that right now so we can see, yeah, come up? And, right. So don't worry. Just comment. Just make a comment.
I did.
Okay. All right. So now I'll refresh really quick here and should have your post there. Yep, there it is. So, but basically this is what you want. You want other people. So then what I'll do at this point is I'll reply. So it looks like Ermine, one of my guys, already did it. You see, here's his post. See that?
Well, the idea is to get several comments, which is going to... You know, people are much more apt to.
Well, it's just, it looks, you don't have to have a lot. You know, 5, 6 is probably good enough. And once I get my 5 or 6, then I will, you know, then I'll go ahead and boost. Then at that point, I'll boost the post. Okay, so when I want to boost the post, this is what I do. Click on boost post. Okay, now there's my ad. So I'm about to create an ad, okay? And you got mobile news feed as well. So you can see how it looks in the mobile, and you can see how it looks in the desktop. Got it?
Yeah.
See that? Okay. So now my audience is going to be people that I choose through my targeting. So my targeting is here. I got to edit the audience. All right, my countries I'm using are United States, United Kingdom, Australia, New Zealand, and Canada. So I picked the countries that I wanted to go to. My age is 28 to 65. I think I might make this a little bit smaller to 25 to 65, and I'm going to do all, so men and women, and there's the interest. The interest I'm doing is network marketing, but you know what? I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to call this one MLM instead. I'm going to change that to MLM and see how that works.
And you only want to put one interest, or you?
Yeah, one or two probably. So I'm going to put multi-level marketing MLM only because it's the same thing, just yeah. one's written out, and so again, this there's a lot of testing you need to do on this. So sometimes it won't work. So I'm just using these two for now. All both sexes, 25 to 65, in all these countries, and that's it. I'm going to hit save.
Right.
And this right here will tell you how many people it possibly can reach. It says here is 1.7 million people that have that interest. So I'm going to change this to $5. Okay. And I'm going to boost this post. I'm going to boost this post for 1 day. And so it's telling me that I'll at the end of the day, I'll probably reach about 3,000 to 8,000 people, which is great. I mean, that last ad, I only reached 2,500, and I got like 15 people, 16 people to respond. So you don't need a lot. And these are highly targeted people because they're people that already like MLM and network marketing. They're responding. They're putting a message on your post, so they are interested in what you're offering. And so then you just go ahead and click boost when you're done.
So you're only boosting these for 1 day, or are you doing it for...
Yeah, I did it for 1 day, and then at the end of the day, it depends on how good the ad's going. If I'm getting a lot of people that are recruiting or people that are responding, then I'll come back and I'll click on boost again, and then I'll just add another $5.
Oh, that's great. Yeah, that's fine.
But if the ad's not responding, then I won't. I'll just create
a different ad. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. But I'm gonna cancel this for now because I'm not gonna read it yet. I got to get some more juice still to this. And so once I have about five or six people that say show me and have some juice on it, then I'll go ahead and do that. Now, when somebody comments, you basically should reply to them, good talking to you, or in this case, hey, Vernon, send a message to my inbox and we can talk there. Because what happens is a lot of people will type in show me or I do, but then they won't send you a private message. And I don't want to have the conversation with them in here in front of everybody. So you tell them, look, send me an inbox, send me a message here on my fan page and I'll respond to you. And that's what all these are up here. When I clicked on messages here, these are all people that have that were my in my other ad have basically sent me.
But I thought sending yes I do, isn't that to your inbox or?
No, it's not to your inbox. That's just on your post. They're just talking to you on the wall. So what they need to do, like if I wanted to send a message to, let's say I wanted to send a message to Todd. This is Todd's fan page here, right?
Right.
I click on message right here and send a message, and now that will not go to his inbox. I mean, that won't go to the wall. It will go to his personal fan page inbox. And so that's what I want people to do. This guy, send me some fuel. Thanks, bro. This is actually Fusi. I signed him up. He's the guy I signed up. He responded to my ad. He put, send me some fuel, thanks. And then I said, okay, Fusi, send a message to my inbox, and I'll follow up with you.
Oh, okay, I see. Now I understand, yeah.
Right. Because I don't want to have the conversation here in front of everybody.
Yeah, exactly. It's just going to be, yeah.
So then Fusi went here, clicked on message, typed a message to me, and then it went to my messages, and then I was able to talk to him behind the scenes. Like I've talked to all these other people as well.
Okay. Now I understand, yeah.
And that's how you create an ad.